Thank you guys for tuning in to Real Love Tarot. Virgos, you're up next, love buds. Today is May 22nd, 2021, Saturday, okay? I'm here to bring you your Real Love Tarot energy read, love energy read, okay? I hope you guys are doing amazing. Hope you are having a great start to your weekend so far, all right? Virgos, let's get into it. If you're new to the channel, thank you guys for watching. Please make sure to hit the like, share, subscribe button. Okay, all new subscribers, welcome to Real Love Tarot. You guys, this message that I'm going to read will not resonate with every Virgo out there. Only take what resonates and leave the rest. Ooh, look at Spirit. Spirit got something to say now. Wow. You guys. If the story doesn't fit, you know, you must acquit, okay? Please only take what resonates and leave the rest, okay? Thank you, Spirit, Divine Spirit, Holy Spirit. Give me more messages for the sign of Virgos and love. We have heartbreak on the board. Wow, we got the Ace of Pentacles in reverse. Ooh, thank you, Spirit. Give me more. Virgos, what's going on, love bugs? I know it's been a minute, but my goodness. What's up? Give me more, Spirit. Thank you. Okay, wow. We got the Knight of Swords and the Page of Cups. Wow. So somebody's heartbroken, okay? And then we have the Ace of Pentacles in reverse. Somebody was doing too much. Going into debt, possibly being greedy, possibly. Somebody's stressing about money here, right? We have a Knight of Swords who wants to come rich in with this love offer, though. But this, but maybe it may not have anything to do with financial debt or whatever, with the Ace of Pentacles in reverse. It could just be they overdid their manipulation in the past, and now they want to come in and fix this. Yeah. Oh, wow. Give me one more, Spirit. Okay. Yep. You gave me two more. Okay, I'll take them. We got the Nine of Cups here on the board as well as the Four of Cups, right? So what's going on with all these cups, okay? Whew. Somebody's hoping for wishes to come true in this situation, right? Mm-hmm. Somebody's feeling guilty about something in the past, though, and wants to come in with a gift. Yeah, whoever you're dealing with, Virgo, they did something and now they're feeling guilty about it. Maybe they overdid their manipulation in the past with the Ace of Pentacles, being greedy in a situation. Yeah. 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 Ten of Wands. Cause now it's a heavy burden. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Spirit. Now it's a heavy burden. Clarify that. Ace of Pentacles in reverse, Spirit. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Four of Swords, yeah, ready to lay something to rest. Mm-hmm. Whatever this was, this manipulation that they were doing in the past, being greedy and a connection, yeah, that now they want to lay that to rest with the Four of Swords here. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Somebody's been resting in solitude, really contemplating, thinking about this. And now we have the Knight of Swords energy on the board. And now that's telling me that this person is ready to, like, make a change in this connection, right? Mm-hmm. They want to come in fast talking on you, right? Seven of Pentacles. Mm-hmm. Something was delayed in the past and they were waiting. Yeah. They were waiting to bring you this love offer, this Page of Cups. What's the Four of Cups? Strength. Thank you. I'm going to put it here. Strength is what they needed. Leo energy. Thank you, Spirit. Wow. Page of Cups. Ooh, the Queen of Pentacles is in reverse, though. She's not going to take this offer, right? Yeah, maybe they were dealing with a person who the Queen of Pentacles who was whoever they chose. This could have been Knight of King of Wands in the reverse. My God, give me more, Spirit. What's going on here, Virgos? Don't worry, I'm gonna clarify with the Hood deck. I got it on lock too. Okay, it's two here. Yeah, the wheel is turned towards this Ace of Wands. Yeah. Somebody wants to come in and bring this offer, but the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. You could have been dealing with regular. You could have been dealing with a greedy queen, right? Because we do have the Ace of Pentacles here too, which is dealing with greed or whatever. But somebody was manipulative. Could have been this Queen of Pentacles who was manipulative or whatever towards this King of Wands. And now the King of Wands is in reverse with on this Nine of Cups. Somebody went through some type of so this was toxic. This is what I'm showing too. This was toxic or whatever, because now this King of Wands doesn't want to come forward, right? This King of Wands is in the reverse now. Yeah, on this Nine of Cups. That's what that's telling me. Because in the past, this King of Wands went towards this Queen of Pentacles, thinking this was on like some impulse, fast action type situation, right? I'm gonna just keep it that way. You guys follow me, okay? This person was overdoing, yeah, they were overdoing. This King of Wands too was overdoing their manipulation. Ended up with a greedy Queen of Pentacles in the reverse, right? Queen of Pentacles reverse. This is a person who was greedy, who was insecure, very could have been insecure, you know what I'm saying? But just envious of of your person possibly, or of someone, something. I'm gonna get it together, you guys. Hold on. But the wheel is turning, right, for this Four of Cups. Somebody wants to come in with an offer because the wheel is turning now, right? I don't know. I'm getting this energy that this King of Wands could be your energy. You chose the wrong queen, right? Yeah. There's a King of Pentacles and a Hierophant here. Somebody had a change of heart or whatever. They're seeing things in this connection differently now. Somebody stepping into their King of Pentacles energy. That could be you, Virgo. Yeah, wanting to invest in something that's like more stable, because this Queen of Pentacles in the reverse wasn't it. Yeah, Seven of Wands. Yeah, so this is telling me too, there was like too many options here in the past, right? Too much competition dealing with this Queen of Pentacles, who is very jealous, greedy. Yeah. Any more messages, Spirit? Oh, that's three. I'm gonna take them because I'm nosy. Yeah, somebody's feeling left out with this Five of Cups energy. Lost, abandoned. Left out in the cold. Unloved. Yep. Yeah, and then we have the Five of Pentacles here too. Somebody's been in self-isolation, due to financial loss. Yeah, with this Queen of Pentacles. Yeah, because this is a greedy person. This person was probably draining your King of Wands like crazy, right? Coven. Or take the roles how they play out, right? But this person, but this King of Wands could have been also being an emotional player in this situation as well, like over, like manipulate, being emotionally manipulative in this connection, right? You guys tell me your story in the comments feel that this resonates with you, right? Because we have the Five of Pentacles here. Somebody is probably going through stress and stressed over being like, financially burdened with this Five of Pentacles. You see how, they're kind of like just like out left in the cold and poverty now. This is what this is with this King of Wands in reverse and this Queen of Pentacles in reverse, right? But then we have somebody here with this energy that's in the King of Pentacles energy. Maybe there's another king here that not maybe there is. There's another king, it's a third party for sure that was left out in the cold or whatever. Because there was too many suitors that there's too many suitors here. There's too many illusions in this connection, right? I wouldn't even take the magician in this one as somebody manifesting. If they're manifesting, they're probably manifesting to get out of this situation. That's the energy that I'm gathering here, right? Let me get a little bit more clarification on this. What's going on, spirit, with Virgos in love? I'm clarifying. I'm doing extra clarification, you guys, with the holy water deck. This Hierophant here, this is a religious card, right? And so the Hierophant that's telling me that this person is coming to some type of aha moment, some new wisdom or whatever, clarity about this situation, right? About what, however their old ways of thinking was. Yeah, something is changing now. Divine Spirit, Holy Spirit, clarify the Hierophant. Clarify the Hierophant, Spirit. Thank you. High Priestess, yeah. Some type of truth is coming out. Something that's been hidden, and some type of truth is coming out. Whatever has been a mystery, whatever secret has been, because the High Priestess, that's somebody's keeping secrets in this connection. Yeah. That they probably got another lover, perhaps. King of Pentacles. Clarify the King of Pentacles. Yeah. That they really have an unparalleled love with this King of Pentacles. Wow. What's the Seven of Wands? What's the Seven of Wands, Spirit? Thank you. Six of Wands. Yeah, somebody wants victory and success in the situation, right? But there's like possibly too many suitors, or there's fear of competition of some sort. From this Queen of Pentacles in reverse, possibly. Wow, Spirit, that's too many. But the crazy thing, we got spiritual partnership on the bottom of the deck, you guys. Yeah, with the Empress. Yeah. This King of Pentacles wants success with the Empress. I'm getting a couple of downloads here. Hold on, you guys. Hold on. Yeah, the Star. That the Empress is a star. Right? Aquarian and energy. And the middle way, the line between opposite extremes. So you and your person is very opposite from each other, right? In the past, your person chose a false queen, right? Queen of Pentacles in the reverse. This person was greedy, only about their money, they sell. You know what I'm saying? Only taking, not giving, okay? That's the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. And then which ended up having you in the spirit of having being the King of Wands in reverse, right? Could be you or your person. Take it how it resonates. Okay, this King of Wands in reverse is telling me too that somebody was weak to this person, right? They were completely weak to this person and not ready to commit properly, right? There's too much competition, too many options around them, okay? You or your person. But now, with the King of Pentacles or whatever, somebody juggled another connection too. I don't know why I'm strongly getting same sex. I'm getting like this could be a same sex type of situation. So, you know, take it how it resonates, whether the divine masculine, feminine is male, female, or both. Yeah, but this is what I'm getting. Somebody's feeling definitely left out of the cold though. Feeling abandoned in this situation with the Five of Cups here. Feeling a lot of grief and regret and loss over this connection, possibly with this King of Pentacles, which is unparalleled love. And wanting victory and success or whatever. We do have the Empress energy here, Libra energy. Okay, you could be dealing with the Libra and Aquarian, Aquarius. Yeah. But somebody overdid their manipulation. Somebody overdid their manipulation and And that's part of the problem here. Emotional manipulation as well. But this King of Wands and the reverse here, that's just yeah. Somebody could be a bully in this connection as well. So yeah, we're gonna see. We're gonna see. Let's get into the backstory really fast. Spirit, divine spirit. Because, child, this is a lot, Virgo. Let's get into the hood cards. Yeah, somebody was a liar. Yeah, I'm leaving it in there until it falls out. Yeah. Somebody was definitely a liar. Who could be dealing with a Scorpio? Put the Empress right here so we could see. Yeah. But this is your soulmate. Yeah, absolutely. Didn't I say? Yeah. This is your soulmate. You're dealing with the Empress here. Yeah. Somebody's Leo energy, the sun. That's the happiest card in the deck. Somebody is hopeful in this situation, right? The Scorpio, possibly. But you got the sun card here. Somebody is hopeful, being hopeful in the situation, and something is going to be illuminated here with the High Priestess. Whatever secrets that was going down or whatever, this Hierophant is just blazing that out here. Something is about to be illuminated in this with this whole situation. It's about to be a tower. I could feel it strongly. Because whatever the case may be, this could be your energy. Virgo, you could be in this King of Wands energy who is weak over this person, right? But then you have a King of Pentacles here who is your real soulmate. You juggled this connection with this King of Pentacles for this Queen of Pentacles in reverse, right? Having you in the King of Wands energy all upside down. Yeah. Initials M, first, middle, last, yours are theirs. Wow. But somebody, yeah, somebody lied too. That's another thing that I'm getting too. Lied is he liar? Yeah. Strength out again. Leo energy. Initials Q, first, middle, last, yours are theirs. J, wow. H, you guys tell me who this is. Yep. Somebody lied. Somebody, there's a liar on the board. Somebody lied about possibly this Empress. I'm getting Empress again. Double Empress on the board. Yes, thank you for confirming. Sorry, you guys. Unawakened. Yeah, somebody was unawakened about this Empress. And was choosing this queen, chose the Queen of Pentacles in reverse instead, and was completely unawakened because somebody lied about this connection too. That's what I'm gathering. Air energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, first, middle, last, Taurus. Yeah. Somebody with the Magician card here, somebody lied to you, Virgo, or whatever, about being with your Empress, possibly. But now the wheel is turning because we got the Ace of Wands in reverse. Somebody was re rejected. Listen. Somebody was rejected in the past or whatever. Which caused a false start or a delay in the connection with the Empress, right? That's what that's saying. I can't even make it up. And somebody manifested that. Somebody manifested a false start with this Empress, which caused you to choose wrong in this connection. Wow. Thank you, Spirit, for the clarification. Give me more. Yeah, that's what I said. Somebody lied. Yeah, initials B. Wow. Wow, you see it? Spirit is like, and then this happened. Yeah, somebody is going through money issues. Yeah. Somebody is going through money issues with the Five of, oh Lord. Yeah, the Five of Pentacles here. That you dealing with this person, this Queen of Pentacles in reverse, caused you to have money issues. You chose wrong. It's as simple as that. You or your person chose wrong in this connection. Having because you're in lack mentality at the time, emotionally withdrawn. Emotionally insecure about what was going on. Thank you, Spirit. Give me more. Yeah. And you guys are mirroring each other now because nobody's speaking. Yep. And now somebody is paying for it. Didn't I say you could be dealing with an Aquarius? Yeah. Star card, Aquarian energies out. Give me more, Spirit. Wow. Thank you. And I want to fix this with you. Give me another chance because now somebody's going through a transformation. Somebody's a, was a, once unawoke, was not woke, and now is waking up. Regret and grief is here again. Intuitive. Because your Empress, that could be the High Priestess. She's the High Priestess. It's intuitive of this connection that there's secrets. Initials T. First middle laugh, yours is there. Whew. Any more messages, Spirit, before I go into the Angel Oracle deck? Let's see here. X. Could be dealing with your ex. And look, Emperor, we have a pair. Yeah, this is your soulmate. This is your freaking soulmate. I can't even make it up. We got the Emperor twice. I mean, we got the Empress twice. We got the Emperor. Yeah, this is your soulmate. And you said, and you really juggled your soulmate over a false person. Who lied, who possibly lied about a situation that lied on your person, your soulmate or whatever, in order to secure you in a connection that was false, because they were a false person. Now you're realizing this, right? And now you want to go fix it with your Emperor or your Empress. Take the roles how they resonate with you, right? Because now you see them as a star. You see them as a star. You want to come in with this happy Six of Wands energy, you know, victory and success or whatever. But now you're feeling left out in the cold because you chose wrong over a false queen. And you, whatever your beliefs were in the past, whatever the case may be with this person that you're dealing with, you're now feeling like you're having a change of heart. This Hierophant card here, this is your belief system, how you view things, how you think, right? And now you're getting some type of aha, having some type of aha moment, like, damn, wanting to do this, have this whole four cups, you know, situation with your person, because you're feeling unfulfilled in this past, in this relationship with the Queen of Pentacles. Some of you guys are still with this person, and then some of you guys have moved on from this person. But all I know is the wheel is here, the wheel of fortune is here, and the wheel is turning. Something is about to change. A significant change is coming, you guys. This is what I'm saying here. A significant change is coming with this Wheel of Fortune. Because, you know, being with this person here, you guys have money issues or whatever. And for whatever reason, you're weak to this person. Like, weak. Like, it's like no matter what they did or said, like, you went for the okey doke. And now you're starting to wake up, because before, like I said, you were unawakened. Now you're starting to wake up and you're like, wow, this person kept you in nothing but grief and regret. And this is your own energy too, because some of you guys, you like, it's such a heavy burden for you. Ten of Wands. Ooh, sorry, these nails, but I love them. Yeah, it's such a heavy burden for you because now you're heartbroken that you even made this decision in the first place. The Empress didn't break your heart. This Queen of Pentacles broke your heart. And now it's a heavy burden. You're completely heartbroken because that's not who you want to be with. And you want to lay this whole situation to rest, to be honest. Because you've been like resting and rejuvenating, you know what I'm saying? And now it's just like, I'm over it. I'm over it. All right, let me get you guys some angel oracle messages, and then I'm gonna let you guys go. Okay. Because this is a lot, Virgos. It happens to the best of us, I have to say. Thank you, Spirit. Let me just move these out the way. What Spirit got to say? Tell y'all what to do about this situation. Give me more Spirit. Give me more angel oracle messages. Okay, that's a lot of Spirit. I don't know. Okay, Spirit, I'm going to go on and take them since you just want to jump out like that. Spirit said, but that's what I want to say. Mm-hmm. Okay, it says, Spirit says, you can't go for what you want if you believe Virgos. And then, but they're saying, wait, you're ready, and then unlikely. I don't know what that means, Spirit. What are they waiting for? If you believe you can have this, it's, you can, but something, whatever your question is in your head, you guys, or you have a certain question in your head for Spirit, Spirit is saying unlikely, but a lot of you guys are ready to move forward because the will is here. Mm-hmm. Like the your fate, like fate is turning, right? This was fated. Yeah. Something could change a year from now, okay? But it's up to you, okay, Virgos? All right, love bugs. That's all that I have for right now. And if you are new to the channel, welcome. Don't forget to hit the like and share subscribe button. And if you'd like to donate, you could do so at Real Love Tarot via Cash App. And the link to my Cash App is in the description box below. Bye, love bugs.